So negative binomial distribution is another discrete probability distribution, which is also mean more similar to the binomial distribution. So if you people understand the basic four properties of the binomial distribution, so negative binomial distribution is very simple, but it will be a little bit different. But as I mentioned earlier, the identification of each and every distribution will be mentioned in a specific question. If you understand the basic concept of each discrete probability distribution, you will be able to identify it. So in the negative binomial distribution, how you will understand, how you will identify that it's a negative binomial distribution, how you will use the binomial distribution, the negative binomial distribution function, how you will use that. So the experiment in which the number of success is fixed. Now there was no such like things, and the number of trial varies to produce the fixed number of successes. Such experiment is called negative binomial experiment. So one thing is different from the binomial and hypergeometric in negative binomial distribution. The number of trial is fixed, but we will play until we not yet get the success number. So the experiment in which the number of success is fixed and the number of trial varies to produce the fixed number of successes. Such experiment is called negative binomial experiment. A negative binomial experiment possesses the following four properties. The outcome of each trial may be classified into one of two categories. So as I mentioned that in binomial, because still it's a binomial distribution, there are only two possible outcomes. It will be a success or it will be failure. It will be effective or it will be defective. It will be a good or it will be a bad. The second property is the probability of success denoted by P remain constant for all trials. So the success probability will not be changed, as I already mentioned in the binomial distribution. So I mean this distribution is also similar to the binomial distribution, but there are something different. The third property is also same as binomial distribution. The successive trial are all independent. So similarly, we have already discussed that all the trials in the binomial distribution will be independent. But in the third, the fourth one is a little bit different from the binomial. The experiment is repeated a variable number of times to obtain a fixed number of success. So this one is the only property which is different from the binomial distribution. That property, the experiment is repeated. We will repeat. They will mention you in the question that you will repeat a variable number of time to obtain a fixed number of success. Mean, for example, if I am giving you a simple example, toss a coin, let's suppose toss a coin 7 times. Repeat it until you get a number of 2 successes, 2 hits. You will toss 7 times a coin and the number of head appear in all these tossing are 2. So now this is a fixed number of success in 2. So in these questions, they will mention you some specific number of successes. This is the binomial distribution function when x denotes the number of trial to produce k success, because as I already mentioned, we will repeat again until we produce. Let's suppose if I am throwing a coin, I will repeat that coin, let's suppose for 10 times. And in those 10 times, I will get 3 successes, 3 hit. Then the game will be finished. The game will be considered as a success. The game will be the winner. When x denotes the number of trials to produce k success in a negative binomial experiment, it is called a negative binomial. When the negative binomial random variable x assume a value x on which the k success occur, the negative binomial distribution is given by. So this is the, just like in the binomial nx p power x q power n minus x. But in this one, because in a specific trial we will produce k successes. So k is the number which show the successes. For example, if I am throwing a coin 5 times, so we will get 2 times head, and head is my success. So k will be equal to 2. So x minus 1, k minus 1. P power k, p is the number of success which will be fixed for each and every trial, and q is the failure probability. So before going to that, I just want to discuss a very simple example. A person throw a pair of fair dice. What is the probability that he will get a total of 7 for the second time on the 8th throw? So now in this question there, this is the first kind of question which we are going to discuss, because in binomial there was no such like thing, but there are some specific number of successes which we produce. What is the probability? He will get a total of 7 for the second time. And he throw 2 fair dice. 2 fair dice for how many time? 8 time he throwing it. And what will be the probability that he will get a total of 7 for the second time? So this second time is the success which we represent with K, which we produce. So first of all, in order to solve this question, you need to understand when you throw 2 fair dice, the total of 7, sum will be 7. So as you people know, the sample space will be 36. And what will be the possibilities of getting a 7? So the possibility is 1 on 1 and 2nd on the other. The possibility is 2 on the first and 5 on the second. The possibility is that 3 on the first and 4 on the second. The possibility is that 6 on the first and 1 on the second. The possibility is 5 on the first and 2 on the second. The possibility is 4 on the first and 3 on the second. So how many possibilities we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it will be 6 by 36. So that is why we just write this is the probability of success. 6 divided by 36. So probability of success is 1 by 6. So Q, how you will calculate the probability of failure? Q is equal to 1 minus P, which is 1 minus 1 over 6, which is 5 by 6. So we just write 5 by 6. This is the failure. Since the number of success is fixed, so as I already mentioned, that the number of try will be fixed. Therefore, the negative binomial distribution, and why we using this binomial? Because we producing K times success. Because they mentioned what will be the probability of getting a total of 7 for the second time. If they mention you throw a coin 7 time, what will be the probability of getting a hit for third time? So now this is a negative binomial distribution. This is not a binomial distribution. This is not a hypergeometric distribution. The trial are independent. The trial are fixed. But they already mentioned, they already mentioned that K time you will produce a specific success. So in this question, second time they say that you will get a 7. So we calculate probability of success and we also calculate probability of failure since the number of success is fixed. Therefore, the negative binomial distribution with K is equal to 2. Why K is equal to 2? Because we will produce the success. In this example, the success is 7 for the second time. So, K is equal to 2 second time. And on the 8th throw, in 8th time we playing it. So, X is equal to 8. So, what will be the probability? So, P X is equal to 8. And so, you people know that the probability, the distribution is X minus 1. So, X minus 1. This is X minus 1. This is X minus 1. And this one is K. This is K minus 1. So, 2 minus 1, K is 2 minus 1. P is 1 by 6. P is 1 by 6 power K. So, K is 2. This is K. This is my K. And this is X minus K. X is 8 and K is 2. And 5 by 6 is the failure probability. So, this will be the probability. Negative binomial probability distribution application. While using this, we will get this probability. Another example. If the probability that a person will believe a rumor about the retirement of a certain politician is 0.25. So, probability that someone believing that a specific certain politician will be retired is 0.25. So, what will be the probability that they will not believe on a specific rumor that a specific person will politician will not be retired? So, Q is equal to 1 minus P 0.75. Now, the question is, what is the probability that the 12th person to hear the rumor that if a specific 12th person heard the rumor will be the 4th to believe it? So now this represents the K success. So in this is the identification of these negative binomial distribution that he she will be the 4th to believe it. So K is equal to 4 and X is equal to 12. So among 12 person, 4th one is the 4th is the person that he believing that a certain politician will be retired. He believing on that rumor. So, this is a negative binomial distribution because we need to produce K success, X minus 1, K minus 1, P probability, success power K, failure probability X minus K. So, 12 minus 1, 4 minus 1 And when we put all these values in the probability distribution of negative binomial distribution, so we will get this answer. So I hope you understand it. Similarly, as we discussed the binomial distribution, mean, hypergeometric probability distribution, mean and variance. So similarly, if you understand, if you want to use these in order to calculate binomial, negative binomial distribution, mean and variance, you can easily calculate. In the previous lecture question, that this question, for example, if you want to calculate the mean and variance, so case 4, 1 minus p, you need to put the p value divided by p. So at this way you will calculate mean, case 4, 1 minus p and p square. So at this way you will calculate variance, and while taking the square root of variance, you will be able to find the variance. Thank you.